Hello everyone, and welcome to another SubQuery video where we're going to talk about one-to-many entity relationships. Stick around to find out more. So let's go into the documentation link here, and we'll go into the Create a Project link on the left-hand side, and under GraphQL Schema, you'll see that here we define the shape of our data in a file called schema.graphql. And in the past, we've looked at very simple objects or entities, such as this one here, where we've got the likes of ID, name, and address. However, as you start building more and more complicated projects, you'll find that you'll need to use the likes of one-to-one relationships, one-to-many, or many-to-many. Here, we're going to focus on the one-to-many relationship because this is very popular. The example here, you can see we've got one person that can have multiple accounts. So this is the one-to-many relationship. First of all, I'm going to set up a project using the standard starter technique. Okay, now that we've got this set up, let's go ahead and open our schema.graphql file. I want to delete this and create my own. I'm going to copy this from a workbook, just to save some time so I'm not typing all of this out. And I'll explain what's happening here. First of all, we're defining an object or an entity called account. And this account has the mandatory ID field, which is actually the primary key of the database table that will be created. And it's set as the to address. The other object is called transfer. And in here, we are recording not only the ID, but the amount, the block number, and also this to address. This is a receiving address, which is actually of type account. So what this means is that in this database table, effectively, there's going to be a column which is going to point back or refer back to the account ID. So this is where your single account can have many transfers. And again, if you're still not sure what this means, when I show you the database table that gets created, it'll help make things clearer. The next step is to look at the manifest file and make some modifications. Now, we're going to just use an event handler, which means we can delete the call and the block handler. And we're not going to filter on balances deposit, but it's going to be balances transfer. And this is something that you'll learn over time. Next, let's jump into our mapping handler. This is really the engine room or the code that's going to do all the hard work. Let's go ahead and delete the code that we do not need, like so. And what I'll do is I'm going to copy the code in again just to save time, and I'll explain how this works. Now, we don't have our starter entity anymore. Instead, we've got accounts and transfer. But to make this available, we need to first of all build the object. So let's go yarn code gen. This will create the associated TypeScripts that you would have seen many times before, the account and transfer. Now I can refer to this up here and import them in. And the key thing here is to know that balances.transfer has the following payload of from, to, and value as an array. This means that we can access these values using event.event.data, and then the position in the array. We're going to ignore the from address just for now and just look at to address and the amount. Next up, we need to instantiate a new account object that you see here. However, unlike defining the transfer object, in this case, we need to check if this value is in the database first of all. This code here attempts to grab the to address from the database, and if nothing is found or if it's null, we can then save it to the database. The reason for this is that one account can have many transfers, and inside those transfers, you could have duplicate keys. And if you don't do this, you'll end up with an error saying that the primary key is not unique. And again, you'll understand this a bit more when you see the database structure that gets created. Down below for the transfer object, what we're doing is again, in the argument here, we are defining a primary key that is comprised of the block number, dash, and then event.idx. IDX is an integer that is unique and represents a specific event. For block number, for the to ID and amount, we extract it as we've seen before, and then we save everything to the database. So with this, let's go ahead and build the code. And what I'm going to do now is run this on my local node instance. First of all, I need to specify a database name. So I'll say now what will happen here is I've got an error saying that the database does not exist. And that's good because I'm doing a cross-check. Now I'll open up my database here and I'll create one. While this node is running in the background, let's go into our database schema where you'll see I've got public being created and also subquery-1. The node has started, so if I drill into this and look at my tables, you'll see I've got accounts and transfers. This aligns with my schema file, and you can see it's already fetching blocks. So if I go into my accounts table and look at the columns, I've got an ID column, which is this one here. And if I go down to my transfers, I've got ID, amount, block number, and to ID, which relate to the fields we've got in our transfer entity. Now the key here is because we're already fetching blocks, I can view this table. And this is the result. So hopefully this should put a lot more context into the data that's coming back and how this all works, because you can see the primary key is actually the block number 197681-4, and 4 is the event number. I've got the actual amount, and this field here, to ID, is actually the unique Polkadot cryptocurrency address that is being stored and referenced to in the accounts table. So there are many of these two IDs in this particular table, but in the accounts table, if we view this, the two ID here is unique. And this is an example of one too many. Now, as this is synchronizing, what I'm going to do is open up another tab here, and I want to run the GraphQL playground or the front end. So let me do some pre-setup. Now, this is the query engine that I want to run, and I can pass it a name. The name is actually the name of the project, which I can grab here. Now, what will happen is I'm going to get an error, and that is because my port 3000 is already in use. So let me export a different port number. And you may well also encounter this error. Let's rerun this. And now we should see the query engine up and running. Let's now go into a browser. Okay, let's now make an example query. We'll start off by going to query, and then I'll query for accounts, and then I'll query for nodes. And I'll say, return all the IDs back to me. I hit run, and now you can see I've got from the accounts table all the IDs showing. Now there's quite a few of them, so let me just increase the speed of this by saying first five, say. I'll run that again, and there you have it. Now I can change this to transfers. So it's very similar to a select query, if you're used to SQL, where I'm saying, give me all the data in my transfer table and just show me the ID. So this is like select star from transfers or select ID from transfers. What I can also do is choose to show the amount and also the block number as well. Now this is a very simple query, but the key is around the relationship that we talked about, because this is indeed one to many. What this means is that from my transfer, I can actually go ahead and discover or link or do a join to the accounts table or the accounts object. And I can do this by saying, also give me two, because this was available, you may recall, in the schema. But if I run this, you'll see that I get an error because my to field has a type of account. So what this means is I actually need to go and specify the actual ID. If I hit run, you can see here now for these transfers, I've got an associated ID, which is actually the to address or the receiving address. So to read this, we've got this amount of dot at this block number sent to this address. So there you have it, a very simple example showing a one-to-many entity relationship for account transfers. Catch you on the next video.